Hey everybody, Chris Farad here. Welcome back to Dark Souls 2. We now need to head down here. We spent a lot of time in this area, actually. We did, we helped a fellow warrior, which was really nice of us, I think. We also... Yeah, you throw that halberd down. Do it. One more. And you're dead. And then there was a guy saying that there was some treasure, but the door locks behind you, so we went and did that, and then he gave us a white sign soapstone, but we already had one, so, I mean, I'm not complaining. But now, this is an area we have to explore. Try jumping and then backstepping. What? Let's just ride the elevator. How about that? Cool. Okay. What do we have here? Whoa! We got potential ambush. Another locked door. A whole bunch of locked doors is what we have. This, however, not locked. Oh yeah, this guy. Okay. Should be fun. Yeah, see, this is what that other tree looked like that we tried to examine. But nothing happened. It had this face. One question I have for you guys is, do you mind if I put the boss titles in the, or the names of the bosses in the videos? Because I'm assuming that if you're watching, you probably played. Oh, but I guess if you just look through your subscription box and you see them, it might be a spoiler, and I don't want to do that to you guys, so, but let me know. This one, I'm pretty sure everybody has seen or played, so. Now, pretty soon, things are not going to get... Pretty soon, things are going to get scary. Whoa! Tantrum! Yeah. That just happened. Just ripped off his arm. What I do need to do is get in there. Just stay behind him. Oh, that was iffy. I'm actually gonna pop this just in case. I'm actually a bit uncomfortable with our current location. Let's bring him out a bit here. Actually, pretty shortly after this, everything's gonna be blind again, which is awesome. Oh, that's probably not good for you. Goodbye. Alright, fun times. Soul of the Last Giant and a soldier key, which I'm pretty sure... I know where that goes. Okay, awesome. That went pretty smooth, actually. That is very exciting. Okay. Soul of the last giant acquired numerous souls, or perhaps many seasons had come and gone, and the giant prepared for his final rest. But his soul remained magnificent, testimony to his former strength. Used the special soul of the last giant to acquire numerous souls or to create something of great worth. I'm really excited to see what some of these, like, boss souls turn into. Yeah, sure, you can have one. Also you. Okay, well, that is a good thing. I mean, I can't really ask for anything better than that. That went really well. Especially how he fell down at the end there. That was the best part for me. Try jumping and then backstepping. Like, I don't get... See, there's a bunch of stuff down there. I'm not sure. Or maybe you... Interesting. I wonder, so if we... do this... Maybe that's what they mean, like jump on there and jump off type of thing. So what happens if I take this ride? Where does this take me? Into this flame, maybe? Or maybe I want to roll out of there, possibly? Whoa, hello. You are definitely not supposed to be here. Weakness leg. Be wary of left. Okay. Isn't this the same area? That is weird. Okay, so it takes us to the same place, but I'm thinking maybe you can roll out of here? I don't know. That looks like something we'd want to get to at some point. Interesting, nonetheless. And since we have all these souls, it's time to Majula it up. And who was it? Did you?
You would. It's kind of a bad.
Did you have one of the... Yes, you have one of the lock stones. So let's take this, now that we have some money.
Thank you, Kai.
Oh, thank you. We'll hit up the blacksmith and see if we can even increase that Hades sword a little bit more. Because we did get two of those Titanite shards from the little lizard that we killed.
I knew you'd be around.
Let's see. We need three. Okay, well, it's not terrible.
Don't waste.
Bearer of the curse, seek souls. Larger, more seek the king, lest this lands. If you find an est... So
thought maybe she would tell us something about the, that giant tree that we just destroyed, but... Okay. I'm still not at the point where I need to definitively decide where things are going. I think it's 14 strength that I need. Let's maybe go a bit into endurance. Yeah, I think endurance is a good one. But adaptability as well. Like, it does poise, it does resistances. I gotta remember that one. And endurance does poise, too. So, I really don't think there's a bad, like, trait to be honest. What is agility? Boost ease of evasion and other actions. I think that's to do with, like, invincibility frames, if I'm not mistaken. And poise, I would really like to crush that. Like, make it really good. So this is how we're gonna roll. And then, what we could do is we could eat a human effigy. And last but not least, we can equip now. Oh, it's 15. Ah, damn. I was one short. Maybe I can eat enough souls here. Ah, that's a nice chunk. Yeah, we should be able to do it.
Bearer of the seek the lest this.
Awesome. Okay, strength. Perfect. Just enough. Oh, nope. Don't want to be doing that. So now let's throw the mace in there. We have a couple more options now so that we're not left stranded if things get hairy. But we can check this out now. And see what he was talking about in his basement here. Giant books. Look carefully. Treasure. Oh, hi there. Oh, another lockstone. Okay, I'll take that. I'm okay with it, for sure. But now, let's go upstairs first. Actually, there's a couple different ways we can go, but check it out up here first. This takes us above the little piglets. I guess if anything, it's nice to catch some fresh air up here. Praise the sun. Fair enough. How's that? The celebrations are very reminiscent of like end zone dances, really. Let's see, I won't bite. Let's change that to welcome. Okay. Feeling welcomed? That's good. To the basement we go. Now this here, this is the map that he was talking about that's carved out of stone. Very cool. Now I don't know, like, we have this one little flame here. I'm thinking the more areas we discover, the more flames there will be, but that is a guess based on when I was playing this the first time. After this, everything's pretty much blind. Like, well, not pretty much. Everything is blind. Wow, you are very tough. That's good for you. An effigy, thank you. I was just about to say, like, I'm worried about these effigies, like how often we're gonna be able to find them. Nice, an Estus Flask Shard, that is huge. what do we have here? A soul vessel? Show this to a certain person and... It can allow reallocation of levels, but without proper assistance, it may simply drain you of souls. If you truly wish to start again, go to the place where your journey began. And this... Okay. So that old lady at the very start was saying something about starting fresh or... I can't exactly remember what she said, but she did say something about starting fresh. Seriously? I think I just got trolled really hard. Damn it. It's embarrassing. Yeah, she was saying you could start fresh there or something. And so what I'm thinking is that you take that soul vessel to her if you want to reallocate all of your soul levels or stats. I'm not sure how that works, but that actually is very interesting to me because I tend to be slightly indecisive, I should say, in how I allocate my souls. Like, it's kind of based on what weapons I find and what I think is cool at the time. So the ability to be able to say, you know what, I've invested all these souls or all these levels here, I kind of like to redo that. That's a pretty cool option to me. What I don't know is how it works. So, like, do I just keep as many levels as I have and then I just do it? I just have all these... I reallocate my points however I want? Like, I have no idea. Shockwar.
Oh. Who are you again?
Seriously?
No, I'm not serious.
Oh, that's actually good.
You do have a rather pleasant scent.
Well, thank you.
The type I'm quite fond of.
I don't know how to feel about that.
Are you going to see the old ones?
I think so.
Those four who have grown, they must have sprouted quite a thick... For heaven's sake.
Yeah,
imagine that. Yes. Oh
yeah,
my.
She's told us all of this.
Haste.
Thank you, Shalquar. Now, here's what we're going to do. We are going to... Go... Oh, look. She's here. That's cool.
Oh, you again.
You said when you saw me next, you might have something for me.
It's on the cheap for you.
Maybe you just meant selling me stuff.
Everyone's so stingy around here. Everyone's so stingy everywhere.
I concur.
You're my only customer. Don't make me beg. Now buy something. We call this place Medulla. Not too special, if you ask me. It's just the place where everyone seems to end up.
Okay, what do you have? Probably just the same items, I'm guessing. I could maybe buy a few of these, just in case. You're very welcome. I will see you soon. Stay fresh out there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is head and kill those ogres that we saw earlier, hopefully. And then there's another ogre at the very beginning who I think dropped something, but I don't know what it is because the first time I ever killed him, I didn't pick up what he dropped. So I am finally going to get to figure that out. And then, if I remember to do it, I'll go back to where I could use the Pharaoh's Lockstone and activate that thing. We'll touch base with the ladies as well. See how they're doing. Let's actually not drop down there just to preserve some health. Take the tree way. Come here. Now I'm gonna try and get this guy to follow me off the ledge. Because that is doable. Whoa. Which I totally figured out by accident the very first time I faced these guys. Because I was really scared of them. Oh, come on. There, come on. Come over here. And... no, look at you, you got some balance. Oh, no, you're gone. That is awesome. See? Man down. There's one. Now this one, I'm gonna have to fight, though. Actually, I wonder, can I... that's actually... well, it's not bad. No! Okay. Let's do this. Come on, swing hard, pal. There you go. Don't like that lightning, do ya? These guys are so goofy. No, what's this? Oh. Oh man, I thought I was gonna die. Now this coffin here, you can get in, and you can change your gender. Don't know why. I have no idea. I imagine... like, I don't know. Because you can't change your looks, as far as I know. But you can go in there and change your gender, and then... I don't know, there's... I'm wondering if there's like a point in the game or where if there's an NPC that only responds well to a certain gender or something like that. I have no idea, but we will certainly find out. I'm gonna touch base with my lady friends here.
Still determined as ever, I see.
I am.
Do you wish to start all over again?
Oh, okay, so this is what I was talking about. I do not. No, I do not. Strowin, that's her name. Did we know that before? So Strowin is one of the old ladies. I'm just taking notes because I try to remember all of these people by name, and I just try to take some of the notes to remember what they talk about.
You must go on a journey. Well, I suppose if you find,
yeah, so
but
this,
if you're willing to start
right.
again.
Reallocate points. I don't know how that works. I'm not going to do it now, but you know what?
No, of course. Now go.
Maybe down the road.
You have proven yourself to the forest.
Okay.
We have little to offer, except perhaps these.
A handmade.
May they bring fortune to your journey.
Awesome.
In some small way.
Thank you. That means a lot to
me.
The
old women.
That really means, look at, this is a ladle, this is nice, I mean, because obviously I would need this for something, I have no idea, but cool, we have a ladle. Now hopefully, this fight against this ogre was as well as the previous one just did. And I'll finally figure out what he drops. Hello. Okay. Oh, butt drop like that. Okay. I like that plan. I feel really trapped in here. I'm gonna run out of space. Drop anything? You do drop stuff. Good. A stone ring. So that's what everybody was telling me about. You missed this giant thing. Okay, it's a ring of additional reduction of enemy poise. That's actually really cool. This beloved ring of the gallant shieldless Lothian, formerly a Ferosa, hits greatly reduce enemy poise. The effect may seem trivial, but for those who comprehend how critical it is to exploit a hole in enemy defense, the significance of the ring will be clear. I think that's awesome, because I hate when I get staggered, like with a passion, it's like the worst possible thing, so that's good news. Now, I think what I might do is just run right to the Pharos Lockstone area, which is things betwixt, I think, Cardinal Tower, and then I can go, like, the normal way. And I'll have to go by those ballista guys again, so... Great. Looking forward to it. Die. Nice, two hits. I don't think so. Oh, really? That's impressive. Oh, damn it. That was not my intention. Though intentions rarely matter. I'm just shocked at how quickly these weapons just, like, get used up. It's insane. Firebombs galore, thank you. I'm not alone down here, pretty sure. There's company, here we go. winged spear and a life gem. Okay, cool. Let's just check out the winged spear really quick. 18 dexterity. Wow. That's really high. Thrusting attacks are effective even against opponents with high defense, but they have a narrow point of contact and won't effectively break through a shielded defense. See, this is kind of cool because it allows for attacks further away, which I think, more often than not, is beneficial. Lockstone. Now, I don't know if all of the things work like this. I also wonder, that just makes me think, if we would have just hit this wall without the lockstone being activated, I wonder if it would open. A chloranthy ring. What is this one? Raises stamina recovery speed, yes. Decorative green blossom. Okay, that makes sense. We have four rings on now. Titanite slab. Okay, that is massive. Reinforces up to 10. Titanite was discovered in an ancient lair. Titanite slabs were created to smith the weapons of the gods, or so the legends say. Really cool. All right, so now what I think we need to do is probably head through to behind that enemy there. And then there's that door that I think we can open with, what is it? Soldier key? Open the soldier's door in the Forest of Giants. I'm pretty sure that that's it. But what I am gonna do is head back to our blacksmith. I'm going to buy a little Titanite chunk from him and see if we can't upgrade this thing one more time. And then we'll head back there. I think at that point, I think then everything is fresh for me again. Like, everything is blind from that point, so. Because I covered, I don't even remember exactly. That's the problem, is that when I did it, we did it as a big chunk of it as a live stream. Oh, that's the soldier key. Where does this take me? Hello. Ring of Restoration? Oh, please tell me that's what I hope it is. Oh, God, this is so good. This is going to help so much. In the sacred land of Lindelt, this ring symbolized prosperity and longevity for the Great House Osteria. But the ring is fragile and breaks easily, as if it hates being taken for granted? What does that mean? How do your rings break? Oh, these have durability as well? Really? Oh, and it even explains. A broken item must be repaired first. Okay, so if it breaks, it's not like the end of the world. But what do we want to not have? I guess we don't need to wear the blue ring. It's very gradual, but it's certainly better than nothing. I think. Head back. So yeah, I've tried to make these first few episodes like a little bit longer than what I would normally do, just so that I can cover off all the stuff that we covered when I played it on the console. So I think now we're like pretty much up to date, which is pretty exciting for me. This even...
I'd given you up for dead. Almost had me worried, really.
Well, thanks. That's great. Let's see. So we need another Titanite shard, which I believe I can buy from you. Hello? Oh, he only has two of them. Or wait, does he have 10? It says held 2. Oh, that means I have 2 existing. I gotcha. So let's throw more into this 80 Knight Sword. And then I could even go further with a large Titanite Shard. I mean, why not? Like, we're gonna be able to get shards down the road and stuff, and I haven't found a better weapon, really. I like the lightning damage. Let's do it.
I'll be around if you make it back.
Is that a shot? Here, let me to see light, however faint.
There we go. I always seem to forget when I pick those up. And let's do... Let's see. Let's go into endurance a little bit more. Why not? I think endurance is a big win. Vigor is actually a pretty significant win as well, but let's go into endurance for now. And when we come back, I think what we need to do is head down to where that ballista monster enemy is, and then behind him, where we were walking straight up to, like, the sun, and there were those two enemies. I think there's a locked door there that key hopefully opens. Maybe it just opens all of the doors in that area. Let's see if we have any more details on it. A fort was erected in the forest to face the giants, but now the soldiers are lost and hollow. They are enfeebled and not without honor. They continue to steadfastly defend their country. Key to the soldier's door in the fort. I don't know, maybe it is just the one door. I'm not sure. I think that's where we need to go. Anyways, guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys are enjoying. I am loving this. It's just such a great experience. And, like, I don't know. I've probably just been talking incessantly about how much fun I'm having. It's just, like, I can't get over it. I'm really just enjoying myself. And I'm really hoping that you guys are, too. So, if you're not, let me know why. And I will try to resolve your issues. Okay, love you, bye.